So what is emulsion? It is a dispersion of one liquid into another liquid. That means an emulsion is a liquid in liquid type colloidal solution. Liquid in liquid type colloidal solution. Okay. So emulsion, both dispersal phase and dispersion medium are liquids. I said earlier that any colloidal solution contain two phases, na? One is dispersal phase, other one is dispersion medium. Dispersal phase is like solute in the true solution. Dispersion medium is like solvent in the true solution. Okay, so here both dispersal phase and dispersion medium are liquids. So in this emulsion concept, it is given by which type of liquids? You know, an emulsion is, it is given by two immiscible liquids. Immiscible or partially miscible liquids. Partially miscible liquids, when shaken thoroughly, when two immiscible liquids or two partially miscible liquids are shaken thoroughly, an emulsion is formed. Next, emulsions are classified into two types. Emulsions are classified into two types. First one, oil dispersed in water, it is denoted by O by W. O by W indicates what here? Oil dispersed in water type. In this oil dispersed in water type, dispersed phase is oil, which is the liquid, and the dispersion medium is water. Oil in water type emulsions, oil dispersed phase, water dispersion medium. For that, see examples. One, milk, where liquid fat is dispersed in water. Second one, vanishing cream. It is in this also, in vanishing cream also, liquid fat is dispersed in water. So, oil in dispersed. What are the examples for oil in oil dispersed in water type emulsion? Milk and vanishing cream. Similarly, second one, water dispersed in oil. It is denoted by W by O or W slash O. So water dispersed in oil type. In this dispersed phase is water, dispersion medium is oil. Okay, examples for this: stiff grease. Okay, second one, cod liver oil. Cod means fish, small fish. So it's liver oil. When it is mixed with water, small amount of water, and an emulsion is made. You know, cod liver oil is used in medicines. Cod liver oil is especially used for asthma patients. Okay, so cod liver oil is which type emulsion? Yes, water dispersed in oil type. Water in oil type emulsion, that is. Okay. So in this, water is dispersed phase. Cod liver oil is dispersion medium. But the name of this emulsion is the name of dispersion medium. In this cod liver oil, what is the dispersion medium? Cod liver oil. Okay. Similarly, cream also an example for cream. Buttercream. That also an example for this second type of emulsion. Okay. Next, you know, emulsions are generally unstable colloidal solutions because two immiscible liquids there, two immiscible or partial liquids. When these two liquids are shaken, for some time only dispersed phase exists. For example, if you take a kerosene and water, they do not mix. They are immiscible liquids. Take a kerosene and water in a vessel, closed vessel, shake thoroughly that kerosene and water mixture. What happens in doing so? Kerosene breaks up into small droplets and simply disperses in water. So that dispersed droplets of kerosene in water is called emulsion. So after shaking for more time, it gives the emulsion. But when you keep that emulsion aside for some time, when you keep that emulsion aside for some time, what happens? Kerosene starts to separate from water. That means two separate layers exist. Kerosene layer as upper layer, water layer as bottom layer. So if two layers separately exist, now that is not a colloidal solution. If one liquid disperses into another liquid, now that is only called emulsion. So an emulsion as a whole, unstable. But to increase the stability of an emulsion, some external substance is added. That external substance added for increasing the stability of emulsion is called emulsifier or emulsifying agent. So let's see what is emulsifier or emulsifying agent. So what is emulsifier? Emulsifier or emulsifying agent. Emulsifying agent. So what is this? It increases the emulsifying agent. Role of emulsifying agent is it increases the stability of emulsion. The stability of emulsion by forming a protective layer around the DP particles. This protective layer prevents the contact of two DP particles. As a result, what happens? The DP particles do not aggregate and do not separate as a layer. So what is the role of emulsifier? It simply increases the stability of emulsion by forming a protective layer around the DP particles. Let's see some examples for emulsifying agents. We have two types of emulsions now. Let's see a list of emulsifiers for both the kinds. What is the first kind? For O by W type, that means oil dispersed in water type emulsions, for this type, the emulsifiers frequently used are, proteins, gums. Okay, proteins, gums, natural or ఆర్టిఫిషియల్ సూప్స్, నేచురల్ ఆర్ ఆర్టిఫిషియల్ సూప్స్. సిమిలర్లీ సిలికా, సిలికా మీన్స్ SiO2, సిలికా మీన్స్ SiO2, కెజీన్ ఎట్సెట్రా యాక్ట్ యాజ్ ఎమల్సిఫయర్స్ ఫర్ ఆయిల్ ఇన్ వాటర్ టైప్ ఎమల్షన్. సో వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఎమల్సిఫైయింగ్ ఏజెంట్స్ ఫర్ ఆయిల్ ఇన్ వాటర్ టైప్ ఎమల్షన్స్? ప్రోటీన్స్, గమ్స్, నేచురల్ ఆర్ ఆర్టిఫిషియల్ సోప్స్, సిలికా, కెజీన్ ఎట్సెట్రా. సిమిలర్లీ ఫర్ వాటర్ ఇన్ ఆయిల్ టైప్ ఎమల్షన్స్, ఫర్ దిస్ సెకండ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఎమల్షన్స్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఎమల్సిఫైయింగ్ ఏజెంట్స్? హియర్ హెవీ మెటల్ సాల్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ లాంగ్ చైన్ ఫ్యాటీ యాసిడ్స్ లాంగ్ చైన్ ఆల్కహాల్స్ ల్యాంప్ బ్లాక్ కార్బన్ బ్లాక్. దీస్ ఆర్ సమ్ ఎమార్ఫస్ ఫార్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్. ఓకే, సో దీస్ ఆర్ సమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ విచ్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ ఎమల్సిఫైయర్స్ ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎమల్షన్స్. యు నో సమ్ ఎమల్సిఫైయర్స్ క్యాన్ ఎమల్సిఫై బోత్ ఆయిల్ ఇన్ వాటర్ టైప్ అండ్ వాటర్ ఇన్ ఆయిల్ టైప్. సో ఫర్ బోత్ ఆయిల్ ఇన్ వాటర్ టైప్ అండ్ వాటర్ ఇన్ ఆయిల్ టైప్ ఎమల్సిఫైయర్స్ ఆర్ సోప్స్ అండ్ గ్రాఫైట్. సోప్స్ అండ్ గ్రాఫైట్ దే ఎమల్సిఫై బోత్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎమల్షన్స్, ఆయిల్ ఇన్ వాటర్ టైప్ అండ్ వాటర్ ఇన్ ఆయిల్ టైప్. సిమిలర్లీ యు నో ఎగ్ ఆల్బుమిన్, what is that? Egg albumin acts as emulsifier in for olive oil in water. So olive oil is used in both medicines and in cosmetics also. So to prepare the emulsion of olive oil in water, egg albumin acts as emulsifier. Similarly, solid mercuric iodide HgI2, what is this? Solid mercuric iodide acts as emulsifier for water in benzene. So it belongs to which category? Water in benzene belongs to which category? Water in oil type. Olive oil in water means oil in water. This is water in oil. So these are different emulsifying agents. Similarly, there is casein. Casein, an emulsifier, na? That casein emulsifies milk. Casein is the emulsifier in milk is also an emulsion. Which type emulsion that is? Yes, oil in water type emulsion. For this oil in water type emulsion milk, what is the stabilizing agent? That means for emulsifying agent, casein. Okay, right. Now let's see some properties of emulsions. What are those? You can dilute an emulsion with any amount of dispersion medium. You can dilute an emulsion by any amount of DM. So an emulsion can be diluted by any amount of dispersion medium. But when DM
is added further.
When you increase the concentration of dispersion medium, the emulsion is simply diluted. But when you increase the concentration of dispersed phase, when DP is added further, separation of layers takes place. Separation of layers takes place. Separation of layers means already in the emulsion, DP is dispersed as a fine droplets. It is dispersed in the medium, na? If DM is increased, DP is increased, then what happens? All the DP particles aggregate and they form a separate layer. That means emulsion is disturbed. So that's not an emulsion then. When the two layers are separated, that is not called emulsion. That is a mixture of two immiscible liquids, that's all, heterogeneous mixture. Okay, so with any amount of solvent, emulsion can be diluted. But by the addition of DP, what happens? Two layers get separated. You know, emulsions also stable due to some sheath of negative charges on the surface of DP particles. So emulsions are generally negative colloids. Emulsions are negative colloids. Because around DP particles, negative charges are adsorbed. Okay. Next, they also show Tyndall effect, and emulsions show Tyndall effect. About Tyndall effect, I had already explained. And Brownian movement. Emulsions like other colloids show Tyndall effect and Brownian movement. Next, these are coagulated by, emulsions are also coagulated by the addition of electrolyte. Just like other colloids, emulsions are also coagulated by the addition of electrolyte. Next, separation of both the layers from emulsion is called deemulsification. So what is deemulsification? Deemulsification is the separation of DP and DM as two layers. If DP and DM separate as two layers, then from an emulsion, if DP and DM are separated as layers, that is called what? Deemulsification. You know, this deemulsification is done by heating, freezing, or centrifuging, etc. So, deemulsification occurs when an emulsion is heated or freezed or centrifuged. Okay, so this is about emulsions.